Good afternoon and welcome to the Liston B. Ramsey Center on the campus of Western Carolina University. 16 months have passed since the last in-person commencement ceremony at WCU, and we are so excited to finally celebrate our graduates on campus. I'm Josh Thompson. I have the pleasure of serving as the Director of Undergraduate Orientation. Thank you so much for joining us for our pre-show coverage of our undergraduate commencement ceremony for the College of Arts and Sciences. These students have worked 4 hard years to be here, and today is all about them. There is no denying that this class of students has experienced college in the most unique way possible, from a solar eclipse to a once-in-a-century pandemic. The class of 2021 has seen it all.
And our newest family members, the WCU class of 2021.
The sun right now. I am seeing that corona of the sun.
We are 10 seconds away.
I invite all the speakers and the Brown family to join me at the podium to formally reopen Brown Hall.
Hello, I'm Allison Morrison Chandler, interim chancellor here at Western Carolina University. We're inspired by you coming here. We are your purple. Proudly be academic.
Without a new natural sciences building, our growth in these important disciplines will slow to a trickle.
Like, I really want this NFL dream to come true. I don't even know, what word can I say?
He took the office of chancellor and he made it into something so much bigger.
Beginning in the fall of 2018, the state of North Carolina will dramatically reduce tuition at 3 of our public universities.
I can't wait to immerse myself in the total Western Carolina University experience and to meeting more members of my Catamount family.
Not every day that someone gets a dormitory named for them just because she needed 9 hours.
We just did that.
We had to do it.
We had to do it.
Opportunity of a lifetime. Never forget it.
Together we can build a consistently highly competitive program here across the board at Western Carolina.
That's why we have moved away from face-to-face classes to online learning and other alternative methods whenever possible for the remainder of the spring semester.
Although neither of them attended WCU, they've certainly earned the right to be honorary Catamounts.
What he gives is out of his heart. Bill is a model for many of us to follow.
Western Carolina University has a brand new vaccination clinic open to assist with delivering it to people in the region.
Every student will walk across the stage, pick up their diploma, have a picture with the chancellor, and have their name announced.
As you just saw, a lot has happened since these graduates started their journey here at WCU 4 years ago, or maybe 5 or 6. And it has taken some serious perseverance. We are so excited to celebrate them today, and we have the perfect guest to get us started. When Chancellor Kelly Brown started her journey at WCU, she probably didn't think that her first spring commencement wouldn't happen until almost 2 years into her tenure. But the day is finally here, and we are so excited to have Chancellor Brown with us this morning. We're also glad to have Board of Trustees member Casey Cooper joining us as well. Welcome, Casey and Chancellor Brown. So, Chancellor Brown, we are officially 1 ceremony down in your undergraduate commencement spring career. How did it feel this morning?
Oh, it was amazing to see the students walk across the stage. Even with their mask on, I could tell they were smiling. I could see it in their eyes. I could hear the audience clapping and shouting for them. It was amazing.
Can you tell us about the land acknowledgement ceremony that will be taking place today?
Yes, this is a very special ceremony that we will be holding that really recognizes the importance and value of our relationship with the Eastern Band Cherokee Indians. And the fact that Western is on their land, their original land, it allows us to be able to understand that the place that we're at and recognize that. And it's a very special ceremony that really takes both for the Eastern Band Cherokee Indians and for Western Carolina University. I'm very excited and very humbled, to be quite honest with you.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown. Casey, what does this mean for the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians?
Well, first of all, I think it means a tremendous amount. Number one, just to acknowledge that there was a very advanced, sophisticated civilization of people that were here, you know, before the university was here. And to acknowledge that in a way that is respectful and that maintains and preserves dignity is absolutely fantastic. The thing that I think it does even more, though, is it symbolizes this ongoing relationship and partnership between the university and the Eastern Band of the Cherokee Indians, a relationship that's based on mutuality and understanding and respect.
Thank you both so much for joining us today. It's a real pleasure to have you both here. Well, it's obvious that the students have had to have some serious grit over the last 4 years, but they haven't done it alone. Countless professors, staff, and family members have been by their side for the last 4 years, and they certainly couldn't have done it without them. We asked a few of our students to write a letter to someone who had a significant impact on their time at WCU. Here's what they had to say.
I'm about to email you something right quick.
Okay.
And I want you to read it.
Do you want me to read it out loud?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay. All right. I'm ready. I'm good to go. Debbie, I would like to express my gratitude for being one of your students.
Dear Dr. Tegan Davis, thank you. You have given me so much over these past 4 years, whether that be a shoulder to cry on, a listening ear, or even a punch to the gut in the form of a hard lesson you were trying to give me.
I know that teachers like you are not easy to find. Each day you came to class with a smile on your face and kind, encouraging words for each student.
As a mentor, you have helped me to reach new heights in both my academic career and in my community service endeavors. To help in bettering everyone around me and help communities that I serve.
أنا ممتن لوجودكم في حياتي ودعمكم اللامتناهي. وإذن الاستماع كلما تقطعت السبل عني أو احتجت إلى المساعدة أو أردت شخصا قريبا للتحدث معه.
Again, thank you. Just doesn't seem like enough, but thank you for making my time at Western easier. And thank you for being one of the reasons why it would be so hard to say goodbye to my undergraduate life.
Lauren, that is so sweet. You're going to make me cry.
Thank you very much, and congratulations for you, bro.
Thank you more, because when I entered college, I was just quiet, never talked. And there are people like you who helped me open up and give my heart out to whatever I was doing and to continuously better myself.
Oh, James, I appreciate that. It's been such a gift to watch you walk this journey and to watch you develop as the young man who is going to go out and make some dynamic changes in the world.
It just doesn't feel like enough. It really doesn't. I truly, truly appreciate you for everything. Even at times where I was ready to quit and give up, you just kept reminding me that I was here for a purpose, that God always has a plan for me. And I can't imagine what it would have been like without you and your presence in my life. So again, thank you, Dr. Takis.
Dads, we are so proud of all that you've accomplished during this crazy, unpredictable year. You have demonstrated grit and resiliency. You have persevered against obstacles and overcome challenges, and you have looked ahead to step forward and make a difference in helping our entire community pull together and serve those in need. Today at Commencement, it is time that we celebrate you and take this time to acknowledge all you've worked for and the goals that you've achieved. I am so proud of you and truly honored to welcome you to your new role as Western alumni. While it may be cliche to say that commencement is the start of a new journey, it's also true. And I hope that you take with you the confidence and experience that you've earned here at WCU. To the families of our grads, I just want to say thank you for sharing these great students, great people with us. I join you in being so proud of their accomplishments and equally their character. These grads have done so much to serve their communities and to lift up their fellow Catamounts. I'm grateful every day for these students and impressed with how graciously they've navigated the challenges of this year. Grads, congratulations again on behalf of the Brinson Honors College. Wherever you are today, know that you are in our hearts and minds. We are celebrating with you this important achievement. Do please keep in touch. You made a mark on this university, and I'm sure you will continue to do so. This is just the beginning of your journey as new WCU alumni. Go Cats.
Hello, students. I'm Dave Kenner, the interim dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, and I'm here to offer you my sincerest congratulations on your graduation. Graduating from college is an amazing and difficult accomplishment. Students must consistently work hard and engage with faculty and other students in a range of experiences, including long writing assignments, in-class discussions, undergraduate research, service learning, and many others. Your learning at Western not only involves showing up for class, but consistently putting yourself out there and trying new things. In creating these educational experiences and challenging you, faculty and staff were not only hoping to help you through your major, we also hope to help you become a lifelong learner and to have the capacity to ask critical questions and make careful observations about the world around you. This is a key outcome of a university education. While succeeding as students is always an accomplishment, you are part of a class that graduated during the COVID-19 pandemic. COVID has disrupted all elements of our society and certainly impacted the ways we teach and learn in the college, particularly for those of you who are residential students. Our programs are designed by fundamentally recognizing that we learn through social interactions with others, a framework and fabric that has been disrupted by COVID. Many of us in the WCU community have worried about our own health or safety or the wellness of family or friends. This worry makes it even more difficult to focus on learning. Despite the difficulties of COVID and the general challenges in college, you made it and graduated. This accomplishment is a testament to your resilience, tenacity, and hard work. As you face other challenges in the future, remember you were able to graduate even during a worldwide pandemic. As we move forward and hopefully near the end of this pandemic, I hope that you may use the many skills, ideas, and dispositions that you learn to help us all heal and build communities that are just, supportive, and kind. We have struggled as a society to find ways to communicate and learn from each other and affirm the value and dignity of all people. Please remember to try to practice empathy, the idea of walking in other people's shoes before judging them. So as you graduate and cross the stage, I thank you for spending time in one of the majors in the College of Arts and Sciences at WCU. We are lucky to have engaged, passionate, and interesting students who call Cullowhee home. I hope you have some time to celebrate your accomplishments with family and friends who have supported you along the journey. We wish you best of luck going forward, and please stay in touch.
There's no doubt the ones we love have a huge impact on a college experience, but it is also what you decide to make of it. Lyndon Jones is a graduate walking today and has no problem making the most of her experience as a student at WCU. With two majors and an unrivaled energy, Lyndon is ready to take on the world after graduation.
Everyone has a gift, and it sounds corny, but everybody has something that they're really good at. And if everyone in the world did what they were good at, they'd be much more happy doing it, they'd be willing to put in that extra time and effort, and I feel like I'm good at spreading messages.
Ironically, I came to Western because we have a great nutrition program. And we have a color guard. And I was like, I want to do color guard in college. It's going to be great. And then I tried out for the color guard here. And the girls were just on a totally different level. You know what I mean? Like, color guard here is so serious. So I came here for nutrition and color guard and ended up doing neither of those two things.
Lyndon's personality is one that I don't even think you meet. I think the personality meets you. She is a bubbly burst of fresh air. She exudes a level of confidence that I think many students strive to just gain by the time they graduate. And Lyndon was a freshman with this confidence. So I think students learn, if they're open to a spirit like hers, that the sky's the limit. Don't ever think that you cannot attain or reach a goal, because the goal is wherever you decide to set it.
When you come to a university, your academics are, of course, what the paper is proving. But what you do with your time in a university is totally up to you. And so how you network and how you make change and how you really do something that's gonna make a difference is getting involved every single day. So this is me going to ICA and saying, okay, what can we do? What can I help with? What programs are going on? Like, what can I learn today that isn't necessarily from school, that isn't necessarily from the textbook? Who can I meet? Who can I talk to?
Lyndon is our go-to. If you see us broadcast any event whatsoever on this campus, we are going to put Lyndon's face plastered all over it, because she just has a way with words. She's just an all-around amazing character that shows up for the department in many different ways.
People get very into, okay, I need to finish school, I need to get these classes, let's do it, let's get it done, I have the paper. And then you have the paper and you're like, wait, this doesn't like provide me entrance into all these places, and it doesn't. And I think that's the scary part. The scary part is we feel that this paper that is a degree is the fix-all or the ticket in, and it isn't necessarily. And so it's important to be a part of that institution in a way that you get the most out of it that you can. So without being part of this institution, without having those opportunities, even if I had the same piece of paper from anywhere else, I would not have the education that I have because of the experiences tied with it.
After graduation, I just want her to be happy, because that is her goal in life. She is not the one that's chasing a dollar amount or chasing a career because it provides clout. She's chasing happiness, so that's my one wish for her.
Having a graduation is the greatest honor. To see me walk across the stage, to wear the heels I picked out, to say, yes, I have a college degree, and this is not the last step, and to literally step forward into the future. It's pretty exciting. I want to go into politics. I want to write books. I would love to open a vegan academy, like a culinary school, but also on how to be a good person, kind of like Plato envisioned. I see myself going so many different ways, that getting this piece of paper that says communication in Spanish is just the start. It is by no means limiting to only me doing radio, to only me doing voiceovers. Although I can do those things too, I want to do everything. And I think that I can. So whenever someone says, you know, you need to focus, you need to pick something, I'm like, nah, you'll see. It's okay if you don't see the vision, just step out the way. I got it.
Well, we are lucky enough to be joined by Lyndon right now. Lyndon, welcome. We're glad to have you here today.
How you doing?
How are you feeling today?
Honestly, I'm kind of nervous. It's been a long time since this many people have like been in the same space as me, you know?
Yeah. What has been your favorite part of your time here at WCU?
Honestly, I had never seen a mountain before I came to Western Carolina University. And so when you come up Catamount Gap and you see that view, I was like, oh yeah, this is the place I want to be in.
Yeah, so when you came to visit WCU, or when you set foot on campus, was that what kind of hooked you and made you decide this was your place?
Oh yeah. Orientation, I met so many people that were like, Lyndon, you need to do this. You need to be a part of this. Have you talked to these people? And I was like, okay, I feel like we can meet a lot of people and do a lot of great things here.
Glad you mentioned orientation, and that's not just a plug because that's what I do. I always love to ask our graduates who are about to leave, what kind of advice you have for students who are going to be starting orientation in the next 2 weeks?
Put your all into it. Like, the only way to do something is to be involved with it. So whatever you like to do, chase it hard, even if that's like gardening or something. Like, do it really hard and do it well, and you'll be good at it.
Excellent. What's next? Any plans after graduation?
So I just applied to a job at this university. This one, no pressure, right? Watch my LinkedIn, you'll find out if I get it or not. So I'm really excited, hoping we can stay in the area and keep going with this network we've built.
Excellent. Well, Lyndon, thank you so much for joining us today, and best of luck in the future and on that job interview. Thank all of you for joining us today as well as we celebrate our 2021 spring graduates. We've waited so long for this day, and we couldn't be more excited for what's to come. We know so many of you couldn't be here today, but we know that you're here in spirit. Be sure to check out all of our amazing graduate features over at commencement.wcu.edu. Enjoy today's ceremony. And as always, go Cats!
Thank you. Chancellor Brown, the graduating students have now assembled for the 2021 undergraduate spring commencement exercises for the College of Arts and Sciences.
Please remain standing as we each pause for a moment of silent reflection on the special meaning of this day. Thank you. Please join in the singing of the national anthem led by Ms. Helena Shropshire, a junior in the music education program in the School of Music.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets roaring, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you, Helena. Thank you. You may be seated. Graduates and distinguished guests, it is a pleasure and an honor to welcome each of you to the 2021 Undergraduate Spring Commencement Ceremony for the students of the College of Arts and Sciences at Western Carolina University. Before we begin today's ceremony, you may notice some changes at odds with our signage on campus. In light of Governor Cooper's announcement yesterday afternoon, we are glad to accommodate and welcome our general admission guests. We also ask that our graduates to keep their face mask on during the ceremony. And we ask that our audience to maintain physical distancing wherever possible from those not in their party. Before we begin our program today, it is my honor to make a special acknowledgement in recognition of our relationship with the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians. Western Carolina University is situated within the ancestral homelands of the Cherokee people, 20 miles from present-day Eastern Band of Cherokee Indian communities of the Qualla boundary. The campus occupies Two Sparrows Place, an ancient principal town with a mound and council house where Killian Building now stands. Cullowhee, the university's home, is Dudacullah's place. Dudacullah, this giant being, was the great teacher and steward of the natural world. And ancient stories about Dudacullah tell of the creator and creation, the origin of humans, and the proper way to be Cherokee. We at Western Carolina University inherit these stories so that we may better understand the deep significance of this beloved place and our role here. Western Carolina University seeks to embrace our place, connect with tribal communities, and enable the success of Indigenous students. We reaffirm our commitment to these goals and recognize that the entire WCU community is responsible for this success. Western Carolina University is committed to enhancing the knowledge and supporting action around Cherokee culture, social, educational, legal, and economic issues. In collaboration with the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, we have built world-class programs of scholarship in Cherokee studies, culturally based Native health, and Cherokee language. This work is rendered particularly meaningful by our position in a deeply significant Cherokee place. As a part of our commitment to actively acknowledge and celebrate WCU as an ancient and contemporary Cherokee landscape, we will work to actively engage our community of students, faculty, and staff with the extraordinary indigenous identity and culture of this special place. It is now my honor and pleasure to introduce to you Principal Chief of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, Richard Sneed. Chief Sneed.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown, esteemed guest, dignitaries, friends, family members, and most importantly, graduates. It is my distinct honor and privilege to welcome each of you to the Western Carolina University undergraduate spring commencement for the College of Arts and Sciences. 2020 and the better part of 2021 have presented challenges that most of us could not have imagined. And yet your perseverance, fortitude, and hard work have brought you to this moment of commencement, an accomplishment that is worthy of esteem, honor, and praise. Give yourselves a big hand. I would like to take a moment to thank Chancellor Brown and the Board of Trustees for their work and diligence regarding the land acknowledgement. It has been said that it is the victorious conquerors who write history. For decades after the Indian Removal Act and the ensuing Trail of Tears, Cherokees and other tribes that were removed from their homelands were ignored in the history books of this nation. The stories of genocide and assimilation have for too long been the silent secret of America. It is only now in our time that tribal nations are being recognized for their rich culture, heritage, language, and contribution to the fabric of American society. On behalf of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, I honor Western Carolina University leadership for acknowledging the sacred land upon which this university rests. May the Creator add his blessing to this institution of learning and to all who shall walk upon these grounds. In our tradition, it is customary to present a gift to honor a bond of friendship. When Europeans first made contact with North American tribes, gorgets were awarded by the Europeans to chiefs as a token of goodwill. These medals were given and worn to indicate that there existed a special relationship between the tribe and the rulers of those governments. In honor of the unique relationship that exists between Western Carolina University and the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, a unique gift has been crafted to seal and signify this friendship. This unique gift is a welcome medal. This medal is sterling silver in an oval engraved in the shape of the Cherokee syllabary for the sound we. The seal of the Eastern Band of the Cherokee and the seal of the Chancellor of Western Carolina University are engraved to the right and left of the spine within the character we. Above and below the spine are the character of the character are engraved Cherokee eagle wands. Eagle wands have been used for millennia to perform the eagle dance and used ceremonially to welcome and honor people. Along the top of the medal are engraved the Chancellor's name and the motto, "Welcome to our homeland." In the center of the medal is engraved Chancellor Brown's confirmation date. Along the bottom of the medal is engraved the name of the Principal Chief of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians. And finally, the welcome medal is suspended from seven strands of wampum, representing the seven clans of the Cherokee Indians. At this time, I would like to invite Chancellor Brown, Trustee and former Principal Chief of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, Joyce Dugan, and Chairman Brian Kinney to join me at the podium for the presentation of the Welcome Medal.
Way high on it.
Thank you, Chief Sneed. I'm very humbled. Thank you very much. I look forward to what the future holds for us together. Also, thank you to Mr. Bo Taylor for the beautiful traditional song he has honored us with today. Is Bo here? And thank you to our audience for allowing us a few minutes to share in this public acknowledgement. Now, please allow me to recognize members of the platform party who do not have speaking roles in the commencement program. I ask them to stand and remain standing as I call their names. Please hold your applause until I've introduced them all. First, members of the University of West Carolina's Board of Trustees, Mr. Bob Roberts, Vice Chair, Mrs. Rebecca Schlosser, Secretary, Ms. Joyce Dugan, former chief of the Eastern Band of Cherokees, Mr. Casey Cooper, Mr. John Lapoli, Mrs. Kathy Greeley, Ms. Rebecca Hart, Student Government Association President and Board Member. Next, the WCU Administrative Staff, Dr. Sam Miller, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, Mr. Mike Byers, Vice Chancellor for Administration and Finance, Mrs. Jamie Rayner, Interim Vice Chancellor for Advancement. Representing all faculty, Dr. Cadence Otto, Faculty Senate Chair. And representing all staff, Mr. Ben Pendry, Staff Senate Chair. Please join me in recognizing these institutional leaders. Mr. Brian Kinney, Chair of the WCU Board of Trustees, will now bring greetings from the board.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown, and thank you to today's graduates and their families, to our alumni, to university leadership, to this university's distinguished faculty and staff, my fellow trustees, and members of the platform party. What a historic day you are part of. It's my great pleasure to bring greetings, congratulations, and well wishes from all the members of the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees. Graduates, congratulations. You made it, even after this year. During these past few years in Cullowhee, I know you've developed lifelong friendships and memories. And over the past year, some were even made on Zoom or WebEx or other virtual means. You have, as the chief said, persevered. And you've overcome obstacles that this past year that I couldn't have imagined when I was going through my senior year here in Cullowhee and walked across this stage a few decades ago. But in doing so, you've also received not only a great education that has helped prepare you for what life will bring your way, but you've developed a sense of determination that will increase your will to succeed. Now, you go get out there and truly show the world what you can do. You're our future, the future of this wonderful mountain region, the great state of North Carolina, our nation and our world. So, no pressure. But we're kind of depending on you guys. I'm confident you're not going to let us down. You have proven over the past 12 months that you can manage just about through anything. If you've ever wondered what the Board of Trustees does, I want you to know that one of the best parts of this job is bragging. Just like your parents, your grandparents, siblings, and friends, spouses that are around you today, we brag about you a lot. We brag about your successes in the classroom, in undergraduate research, in community service, about your being players of the week for various SoCon sports, and about your artwork and about your performances. Your achievements reinforce our pride in this university. Thank you for all you do, and more importantly, what you will do to make us proud, because we are today and will forevermore be very, very proud of you. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Chair Kinney. We certainly appreciate your participation in our ceremony and bringing greetings from the Board of Trustees. Mr. Philip Byers, member of the University of North Carolina Board of Governors, will now bring greetings from the board and from the Office of the President. Mr. Byers will also present the Board of Governors Award for Excellence in Teaching to Dr. Catherine Carter.
My notes are long this afternoon, so if the concession stands are opened, I read slow and talk slower, so it may be a good time for you to go to the concession stand. I'd rather you wouldn't, but if you need to. I didn't just arrive from Chapel Hill. I, too, am a Catamount. I graduated in 1999 with a master's degree from this fabulous university in public affairs. I did say 1999, like Chair Kinney, who graduated in 1969. Chair, always good to see you. Greetings from the UNC Board of Governors and the system staff. To you graduates, it is a delight to look around today and see the joy in your eyes and your family members and friends, smiles on faces, and to share the excitement of this moment. Collectively, we acknowledge the long hours of hard work it took for you to get to this point. We honor you today for the commitment that you have demonstrated to better your life by obtaining your degree. In doing so, you not only have done something important for yourself and your families, but you have also accomplished something that improves your communities and our world. As individuals, each of you have much to celebrate. But West Carolina University is reaching great milestones too. I want to mention just a few of those today. First, I would be remiss if I did not mention the dynamic leadership being provided by Chancellor Kelly Brown, who is getting to experience for the first time a spring commencement since we were deprived of such last year due to the pandemic. I want you to join with me in thanking our wonderful Chancellor for her hard work and dedication. I realize Chancellor Brown has been very impressed by WCU's faculty and staff and their dedication to student academics and overall student experience here in Cullowhee. One example of the great work of your faculty is a $583,000 grant from U.S. Department of Education for an after-school program for Cullowhee Valley School, where the children speak English as another language. Also, how could I not mention your faculty, staff, and the students for quickly setting up a COVID-19 vaccination clinic, rapidly completing the backlog for Jackson County, and expanding to provide vital resource to the entire Western North Carolina region. This is a historic feat for Western Carolina. Well done. I was honored to speak before the entire Board of Governors about that situation. Had on the board listed all 17 universities that we govern, and at the very top of all those that had been vaccinated and the great job that had been done was your chancellor and Western Carolina University. For that, I am very proud for what you continue to do for Western North Carolina. Thank you. I don't want to forget to mention how hot a commodity Western Carolina University is, as this institution once again set a record for enrollment this past fall. A variety of factors are playing into our increased enrollment, the great work by our faculty and staff, as I mentioned before, and the status we hold as part of North Carolina, UNC System's North Carolina Promise Program that lowers the cost of tuition for students at Western Carolina University. Great things are happening in Cullowhee and across the entire state of North Carolina. Collectively, our 17 UNC campuses comprise a public university system that is among the best in the country. You graduates will receive the benefit of that reputation as you go into the workforce or continue your education. As you go into living your lives, I encourage you to take time to savor the memories and all the moments you spend as a student at Western Carolina University. Stay connected to this wonderful school and its people. Meet here often, and as you start those new jobs and are making money, please bring lots of money back to Cullowhee, North Carolina, so we can continue our enrollment increases and provide the same wonderful education that you've been provided to students in the future. Congratulations, graduates, and enjoy this day. You deserve to celebrate, but it's important to acknowledge the contributions of the faculty and staff of Western Carolina, especially those teachers who have helped, encouraged, and provided you with the proper guidance to succeed. There are a number of faculty members on this campus who exemplify outstanding teaching. Today, I am honored to recognize one of them. It is my privilege to present this year's Board of Governors Award for Excellence in Teaching to one of your most outstanding faculty members. Established by the Board of Governors in 1994 to underscore the importance of teaching and reward great teachers across the university system, the awards are given annually to a tenured faculty member from each UNC campus. Recipients are nominated by special committees on their home campuses and selected by the Board of Governors Committee on Personnel and Tenure. Each winner receives a bronze medallion and cash award. This year's recipient from Western Carolina University is Dr. Catherine Carter. I ask Chancellor Brown and Dr. Catherine Carter to please come forward. I was planned, I had the honor of spending some time with Dr. Carter at lunch, and I was prepared to share with you that the winner got a home in Malibu and one at Palm Beach and $10,000 a week for eternity, but she didn't want me to share that part with you. Dr. Catherine Carter, Western Carolina University Professor of English, is being honored this spring as one of University of North Carolina System's premier teachers. She is among 17 recipients of the University of North Carolina Board of Governors Award for Excellence in Teaching. A member of the UNC faculty since 1999, Carter received her doctorate in American literature, but soon afterwards was drawn to English education. She credits Dr. Mary Warner, a former director of WCU's English department, for getting her interested in this field. When Warner left WCU in 2004, Carter took over as director, a role she filled until 2014. Dr. Carter is the author of poetry collections, Marks of the Witch, The Swamp Monster at Home, The Memory of Gills, Larvae of the Nearest Stars. Her work has appeared in publications such as English Education, Studies in American Fiction, Orion, Poetry Plowshares, Cortland Review, Tar River Poetry, Asheville Poetry Review, and Best American Poetry 2009, among others. Carter's poetry has won regional awards, including the Roanoke Cho-In Award 2007, James Applewhite Poetry Prize 2018, Kajar Press Annual Chapbook Contest 2014, and the Randall Jarl Poetry Competition in 2009. Carter was recognized by WCU's College of Education and Allied Professions as an outstanding field supervisor, as nominated by you, the students, from 2016 until 2019. She received the Chancellor's Award for Meritorious Service to Students in 2006 and was a finalist for the Chancellor's Distinguished Teaching Award in 2015-2016. Again, established by the Board of Governors in 1994 to underscore the importance of teaching and to reward good teaching, awards for excellence in teaching are given annually to tenured faculty members from the entire UNC system. Dr. Carter, we celebrate your outstanding professional achievement and salute your demonstrated commitment to great teaching and inspiring a new generation of learners. In honoring you, we also acknowledge the more than 14,000 dedicated faculty members who teach over 220,000 students throughout the University of North Carolina. Congratulations, Dr. Catherine Carter, and thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Byers and Dr. Brown. I really appreciate it. It has been a strange year. I guess you all have noticed that. A commencement address is supposed to offer good advice to the graduates. And normally, there are some experiences that are common to all graduates. But this year, each of you has been struggling with different obstacles. I hope that most of you had at least one person in your corner helping you to survive. But I know that a lot of you also felt all alone. So the best advice I can give you for next year and the years after that is to remember this year, which is your year, when each of you was struggling with things that people around you didn't always see or understand. Maybe your professors expected you to be more than full-time students, while your families needed you to be there more than full-time for them. For some of you, maybe the worst problem was money. For others, it was the isolation. Some of you have been sick. Some of you have lost people you loved. Some of you have had your paths made harder by cruelty or assault or the biases and oppressions that are still built into way too many institutions. And some of you have dealt with all of these things at once. I'd like to paraphrase the novelist Angie Thomas from her second book when she points out that while some people are playing checkers, other people are having to play chess. And as you know, the rules in checkers are pretty straightforward. In chess, not so much. I will give you an example of this from your own class. I work mostly in English education, so I'd like to tell you a story of someone who is, I hope, here today, who became a teacher this year, and what she learned about checkers and chess. Your classmate Jordan had a student of her own who was transitioning from one gender to another, and your classmate was able to connect with this student by using his preferred pronouns. But when it came time for the parent-teacher conference, she wasn't sure what to do. What could the teachers tell the parent? How much did the parent know? How did she feel? Which pronoun should they use at this conference? And Jordan took the initiative to find the student and check with him and learn what to say at that conference. She didn't require the student to play by her rules. She asked him what rules he was actually playing by. And your classmate did this while she was also working on a huge multi-part portfolio, the EdTPA of not so fond memory, and teaching full-time in an on-again, off-again hybrid online setting, and doing all of the evening and weekend grading and planning that teaching requires, and raising three kids of her own in a pandemic, which meant that each child's school and daycare arrangements were different. She could have said, "I've got enough problems, and this is not my concern." She could have said, "I'm the teacher, so I'm more of an expert on the student's experience than he is." But instead, Jordan recognized that her student was playing chess instead of checkers, dealing with issues that were different from her own. And so she was able to join his chess game for a few moves to help support him. So as you go on into what I really hope will be better years, you could have worse models. It will be worth remembering how you struggled this year with things that other people couldn't always understand. Because everybody you meet, they're going to be doing that too. The struggles are not going to end when the pandemic does. At this point, I would also like to quote my friend Sanda. When I was having a bad day, she told me, "You have to remember that the world is full of crazy jackasses." And I should add that she didn't really say jackasses. Sanda has the vocabulary of a very well-read and multilingual sailor. But this is a formal occasion, so we will stick with jackasses. So I said, those people I was dealing with, they sure were some crazy jackasses. But then Sanda went on, and you have to remember that some days you're the crazy jackass. I did not like that nearly as well, but I have to admit that she had a point. Some days I am the crazy jackass. Some days I forget that my experience is not everybody's experience, and that other people are struggling in ways I can't see. And as my mother and my father like to say, nobody is all one way, including me. So I encourage you to remember, even if it is painful, how you have struggled this year. I encourage you not to let anybody tell you that because someone doesn't look like you, or doesn't worship like you, or doesn't vote like you, that person isn't really struggling, maybe in ways that you can't imagine right now. And I encourage you not to forget that we all have days when we're the crazy jackasses. So with that in mind, it is usually worthwhile to extend people the benefit of the doubt. It is worth considering asking them what they are struggling with that you can't see right now, because they can probably tell you, just as you could tell people what you have been struggling with. Try not to assume that if you happen to be lucky enough to be playing checkers today, everyone else must be playing the same game with the same rules, or that if you were able to overcome 3 challenges, in which case, congratulations, everyone else has the resources to overcome 12. And try not to assume that if there is a crazy jackass in the room, it must be that other person. So when in doubt, try to be kind. I cannot promise you that this will always work out, and it will not mean that there won't be other pandemics and other games of chess and other crazy jackasses. There totally will. But I think I can promise you that you will very seldom regret it. So thank you so much, graduates, and so many congratulations on making it to this day.
Congratulations, Dr. Carter, and thank you so much. Mr. Byers, thank you. We certainly appreciate your participation at our ceremony and your words of congratulations to our students. You are a good friend and supporter of the university, and we appreciate that. From time to time, universities choose to recognize outstanding achievement by awarding honorary degrees. Today, Western Carolina University awards an honorary doctorate to Mr. Thomas N. Belt, and I ask him, Chairman Kinney, and Provost Starnes to join me at the podium to accept this honor. Thomas Belt, your dedication and contributions to the preservation and revitalization of the Cherokee language and traditional culture have had profound significance for Western Carolina University, the region, and the nation. Raised in a Cherokee-speaking family in Rocky Ford, Oklahoma, you were active in the efforts to advocate for Indian rights and Native culture. You moved to the Eastern homelands in the early 1990s, and you continue to live on the Quala boundary of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians, where you first worked as a teacher in the Cherokee Central Schools for 7 years, and then worked with troubled Native youths in the Unity program. As a teacher and scholar at Western Carolina University from 2005 to 2018, you developed vital materials for teaching Cherokee language, and prepared multiple cohorts of students to read, speak, and teach Cherokee language themselves. Your written and spoken works and appearances in widely publicized documentary films are irreplaceable records of Cherokee language and culture that have been and will continue to be used by generations of students, scholars, and Cherokee community members. You worked with the American Philosophical Society and the Smithsonian Institution to develop and enact protocols for the treatment of Cherokee archival materials, in particular, cultural sensitive materials in the Cherokee language. This work has helped to make the archives of these institutions more open and accessible to Cherokee communities. You served as a consultant to these national institutions and multiple university programs, providing regular addresses and workshops at UNC Chapel Hill, Stanford, Yale, Duke, and Wake Forest universities regarding the importance and significance of indigenous languages and the worldview of Cherokee culture. You helped us as campus leaders understand the possibilities and true potential of Cherokee and Native American studies at WCU. You helped us understand that our work is about more than one particular discipline, and instead that we have the potential to transform Western Carolina University for everyone's benefit in light of Cullowhee's identity as an ancient Cherokee place. You brought the Cherokee world to us and translated that world into ways that non-Indigenous students, faculty, and staff could access and begin to comprehend. You are truly a treasure of Western Carolina University. Your impact is far-reaching, and your quiet wisdom, eloquence, and persuasiveness have touched and changed many hearts and minds. Perhaps most importantly, you have been a central figure in the preservation of the ancient, sacred mother town of Kadua. You are in so many ways the leader of the broad reawakening of Cherokee traditional thought and identity. You are a leader in the best Cherokee sense, the one that carries them like a child, never ceasing in your efforts to use every tool to restore tohi, balance and well-being for everyone, and to see Duyukta, the right path, as reality. And today, in recognition of your remarkable career and your invaluable service to this university and to our state and nation, the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees is pleased to award and the Chancellor to confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, at this ceremony, at this commencement ceremony, on the 15th day of May in the year 2021, with all the rights and privileges thereto appertaining.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown, Chief Sneed, former Chief Joyce Dugan, and Provost Starnes. Thank you, Western Carolina University Administration, faculty, alumni, friends, and family who are with us. And those who will be with us forever. Today, I offer my heartfelt thank you to all the departments and staff of Western Carolina University, and especially extend my congratulations to you, the graduating class of Western Carolina University 2021. This day honors all of your efforts for the success you have achieved in your academic endeavor. And it inspires me to recall something that my father conferred to me in my childhood. When I made mistakes in judgment, and believe me, there were many, he would admonish me in the Cherokee language with these words. Real human beings do not do that. I've contemplated those words my whole life. Today, you stand on the threshold of your very own future, a future that will be sculpted to your specifications by your own hands. My hope today is that if in that future you were ever asked these three questions: do you believe that cultural diversity is a key factor to human sustainability? Do you believe that a sense of gratefulness and respect should guide the natural sciences in the understanding of the world we live in? And do you believe that logic and reason are the methodologies that ensure a better world? I sincerely hope that in that future, your answer will be always, always, always. As of this day, you have earned the privilege of being able to say, because that is what real human beings do. Thank you all so very, very much.
Congratulations, Dr. Thomas Belt. That sounds pretty good, right, Dr. Belt? Yes, yes. At this time, Provost Richard Starnes will recognize the university scholars and begin today's presentation of candidates for degree.
Chancellor Brown, it is my pleasure to recognize those students who enrolled as freshmen at Western Carolina University and who have completed their entire undergraduate careers with a perfect record, a 4.0 grade point average. Having consistently met the rigorous standards of our faculty, they deserve the special recognition as university scholars. I ask the following individuals to stand and be recognized during the spring commencement, and please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Colton Anderson, Caitlin Bell, Catherine Betts, Jordan Cuthbertson, Nate Hadley, Montana Henson, Mary Jensen, Amelia Coda, Devin Woody. Congratulate these outstanding accomplishments. Chancellor Blunt Brown, it's now my pleasure to call upon the deans of the colleges to present to you the candidates for degrees. Dr. Jill Granger, Dean of the Brinson Honors College.
I ask all candidates for degrees who are members of the Brinson Honors College to please stand and remain standing. Chancellor Brown, the Brinson Honors College is pleased to present candidates who will graduate with full honors. Candidates who are graduating with full honors are distinguished by the honors medallion.
Dr. David Kenner, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences.
I would like to ask all candidates from the College of Arts and Sciences to please stand up and remain standing. Chancellor Brown, the College of Arts and Sciences is pleased to present these candidates for Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Science degrees.
Chancellor Brown, all candidates for degrees are hereby presented.
Thank you, Provost Starnes. I ask all the faculty present today on the platform and in the audience to stand and remain standing in support of these graduates and as a confirmation of their meeting of the rigorous standards set forth by the university. I now ask all Western Carolina University alumni present today on the platform and in the audience to stand and remain standing as witnesses to the conferral of these degrees and the acceptance of these students into the ranks of loyal alumni. Upon the recommendation of the faculty, by the authority vested in me by the University of North Carolina Board of Governors and the Western Carolina University Board of Trustees, and upon their completion of all degree requirements, I confer upon these candidates the degrees for which they have been recommended with all the rights, honors, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Please join me in congratulating our newest graduates. You may be seated. Graduates, each of you have worked diligently, passionately, and tirelessly, earning the distinct privilege to be seated before us today. You have believed in your dreams. You have set your sights on your goals. You have weathered a once-in-a-century pandemic. You have completed all the necessary and difficult tasks to reach this day. A day that represents one of the most significant milestones in your lifetime, a milestone that makes possible a future of unlimited possibilities. It is your hard work and perseverance that is the main reason you are here today, the culmination of many long nights researching in the library, hundreds of hours of study and homework, many months in classes and internships. Hundreds of hours collaborating with classmates, numerous evenings attending special events on our campus, and the list goes on and on. You hung in there no matter how tough it got, working with tutors and advisors, meeting with professors and staff. You have worked so hard to make it to this day, and now you are here. As citizens of the world, we face many challenges and opportunities. Excellent health care for a changing population, innovation in an age of automation and robotics, development of sustainable earth-friendly energies, access to affordable and quality education, construction and design of energy-efficient homes and buildings, the creation and performance of art and music, and the continual discovery in how to maintain beauty and biodiversity of places like Western North Carolina, while simultaneously supporting a burgeoning hospitality and tourism industry. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. Graduates, it is now up to you to create the world in which you wish to live. It is your freshly born ideas that will create sustainable environments. It is your vision of the future that will eliminate poverty and hunger. It is your ability to take your educational experience and apply it to create international innovation and collaboration. And most importantly, it is your ability to believe in peace, justice, and equality that will make that a reality for all. Graduates, the future is yours, and the world is counting on you. We live in exciting times, a time where employment opportunities offer unique and fulfilling experiences. Many of you have already secured interviews or job offers, have plans to attend graduate school, or have come back to school to complete a degree that you have maybe begun many years ago. As I look out at the passion and energy, the hope and resilience, I must say, we are proud of you, our Catamounts. Graduates, once upon a time, we stood before you to lead the way. Today, we stand behind you, ready to follow. And we stand beside you, ready to serve as you lead us into the future. Congratulations and go Cats! I now ask that all degree candidates to step forward to receive their diplomas.
Please note that those students graduating summa cum laude, magna cum laude, or cum laude wear the gold cord. Candidates who have served or are currently serving in the United States Armed Forces wear the red, white, and blue cords. Some graduates are wearing cords, stoles, or pins denoting their participation in or affiliation with an organization. Since each individual graduate is recognized by calling their name as they walk across the stage, we ask the entire audience to respect the graduates and their families by refraining from the use of artificial noisemakers, such as air horns. We also ask that you remain seated and stay for the entire ceremony. From the Brinson Honors College, College of Arts and Sciences, Hoy Genoa Haddon, cum laude. Catherine Tyler Betts, summa cum laude. Kenna Rose Betts, summa cum laude. Kristen Michelle Franklin, cum laude. Griffin Beecher Tracy, summa cum laude. Ethan Edward Leatherman. Alethea Noel Williams, summa cum laude. Michaela Grace Cox, cum laude. Mackenzie Michaela Lucas, magna cum laude. Hannah Marie Smathers, cum laude. Michaela Doan Deese, cum laude. Ryan Patrick McGinty, magna cum laude. Devin Taylor Woody, summa cum laude. Taylor Brooke Sanderson, magna cum laude. Grace Cecilia Tax, magna cum laude. Jubilee Olivia Lucille Padilla, cum laude. Michaela Janelle McIntyre, magna cum laude. Mary Bailey Jensen, summa cum laude. Catherine Elizabeth Sherrill, magna cum laude. Jamie Bowden Blaylock, summa cum laude. Jordan Nicole Fox, summa cum laude. Dawson Hicks Spencer, cum laude. Morgan Jesse Mays, magna cum laude. Joshua Scott Geiger, summa cum laude. Caitlin Francis Bird, cum laude. Sophia M. Spangler, magna cum laude. Amelia Claire Conda, summa cum laude. Patrick Owen Barchett, summa cum laude. Morgan Keith Suttereth, summa cum laude. Austin Cassidy Lloyd, magna cum laude. Nick Fentham, cum laude. Ashley Elizabeth Nelson, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Sellers, summa cum laude. Gabriel Calvin McCoy, summa cum laude. Sarah Marie Martinko, magna cum laude. Nathaniel Jacob Hadley, summa cum laude. Jose Manuel Ruano, cum laude. Montana Joe Henson, summa cum laude. Madison Danielle French. Brianna Lee Barazansky, summa cum laude. Craig Allen Cook, cum laude. Brittany Diane Turlington, magna cum laude. Carly Marie Briggs, magna cum laude. Joshua Hunt Adcock, magna cum laude. Brittany Ashlyn Smith, summa cum laude. Brandy Alexandra Dillingham, summa cum laude. Jayla Ann Bogard, magna cum laude. From the College of Arts and Sciences, Autumn Elena Pine, cum laude. Cole Gregory Falk. Susan Evie Kenny, magna cum laude. Zachary James Wyatt. Jordan Page Mills. Lacey Nicole Jones. Christopher Cole. Dylan Chance Paris Vasquez. Aurora Joy Chambers, magna cum laude. Miranda Danielle Moore. Brianna Brichet Tuft. Kelsey Claire McDaniel, summa cum laude. Annika Adair Mahan, cum laude. Nathaniel Gregory Smith, summa cum laude. Madeline Claire Harrison. Sydney Blake Coffey. Cynthia Barum Chavez. Caitlin Rose Claus. Jalen Noel Meads. Pierce Kennedy London, cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Jocelyn, cum laude. Wesley David Hensley. Brianna Lee Cowan, summa cum laude. Hagen Jensen Boggs. Ian Chance McPherson, magna cum laude. Carrie Banks Hockman, cum laude. Kristen Elizabeth Tuck. Shane Cole Birch. Hunter Bailey Willis, cum laude. Aaron Scott Anthony. Casey Marie Clower. Jordan O'Neill Cuthbertson, summa cum laude. Kaylee Grace Hand. Wyatt Edward Borum. Maxwell Austin Dumas, magna cum laude. Rodrigo Alonso Silva. Tiffany Daniel Daniels, summa cum laude. Carly Marie Yancey, cum laude. Ashton Bailey Paulson, magna cum laude. Alonzo Green, cum laude. Casey M. Richardson. Jeremy Tyler Jones, magna cum laude. Anna Muriel Voss, cum laude. Caitlin Celeste Gregory. Stephen L. Gary III. Julius Scott Michelson. Lara Ray Rose Green. Jeremy Brian Cleeton, magna cum laude. Diana Corbett Lewis, magna cum laude. Eric Rubley. James Matthew Joyner. Callie Emmeline Dinkins, summa cum laude. Muaman Ryan Hang, cum laude. William Everett Bolin. Gregory Robert Seisner. Sadie Madison Deal. Darius Jamal Archie. Rolanda J. Hayden. Casey Ann Robinson. Dylan Gage Ramsey. Aliyah Jordan Swimmer. Michaela Skye Sawyer. Jacob Wayne Monroe. Alicia Reagan Pope. Waleed Mohammed Khalil, cum laude. Kristen Sassy Washington, magna cum laude. Beverly Jean Lynn Stau. William Travis Driver, cum laude. Eleanor Grace Armstrong, cum laude. Josue Cruz. Rory Daniel McNeil. Aaron M. Johnson. Meredith Brooke Stone. Marion Tarver May. Madeline Grace Brewer. Ginny Hayes Lehman. Sarah Elizabeth Cheney. Zach Dalton Worley, summa cum laude. Laura Rose Grace. Stephanie Faye Gordon, magna cum laude. Santiago Garcia. Julissa Judith Jain. Devin Claire Welch. Karen Miranda Reddish, cum laude. Bailey Samantha Fex Overton. Patricia LaVon Norton, magna cum laude. Brianna Taylor Herring. Joshua Anderson Everhart. Lindsay Michelle Griffin, cum laude. Andrew Tyler Rhodes, summa cum laude. Jessica Michelle Bell, magna cum laude. Brittany Lachey Windham. Austin Kelly Cole. Haley Elise Whitaker. Michael Maurice Tiomno. Celeste Marie Pruitt. Desmond Malachi Worrell. Jessica Lauren Wash. Audrey Lee Sylvester, magna cum laude. Gamble Baker Ward, cum laude. Alan Micah Harris, cum laude. Patrick Lee Clemens, cum laude. Sierra Elizabeth Lyons, magna cum laude. Amy Scarlett Thompson, summa cum laude. Noah Michael Taylor, magna cum laude. Madison Jean Johnson. Mary Brooke Williams. Brian Norwood Bailey. Lauren Elizabeth Timmerman. James Thomas Reinemann. Jacob Alexander Gash. Crystal Hernandez Venegas, magna cum laude. Molly McRae Boren, cum laude. Chase Garland Spicer. Jennifer Lynn Cook, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Hope Bridges, magna cum laude. Victoria Lane K. Bullis. Joseph Anthony Yoakum. Alina Divine Opoku. Jada Alexia Harris. Nicole Linden Jones. Michael Lucas Bergen. Matthew David Baer. John Robert Hoover, magna cum laude. James Michael Carroll, cum laude. Jacob Isaac Punch. John Christopher Palmieri, magna cum laude. Jordan Haley Gardner. Margaret Catherine Thornburg. Haley Michelle Capps. Matthew Christopher Dunning, cum laude. Austin Kenneth Burnett. Abby Marie Kincaid. Hannah Michaela Coates, cum laude. Noah Michael Elliott. Mackenzie Schuyler Allen. Jordan Radimus Crowell. Christopher Allen Ingram Jr. Noah Riley Clark. Cole Stewart Walker. Chelsea Marie Parton, summa cum laude. Ansley May Carter, cum laude. Morgan Elizabeth Smith. Brianna Grace Castro. Tyler Allen McVeigh. Morgan Sierra Wiley. Ana Laura Cruz Hernandez. Owen Ray Parker Jr. Noah Christopher Moore. Patrick Cavallaran. Caleb Derek Charles Johnson. Catherine O'Condon. L. Daniel Tizan. Taylor Mariah Nicole Wellborn. Zachary Aylin Carr. Stephanie Pitts Miller, magna cum laude. William Reese Borstelman. Michael Edward Jones. Tyler Austin Green, cum laude. Morgan Michelle Bailey. Zachary Tyler Garner. Mitzi Salmaron Garner, summa cum laude. Debbie Jarlene Badillo, summa cum laude. Jules Francis Sanapoli. Emily Nicole Womack. Logan Hunter Smith. Charles Matthew Wright, summa cum laude. Brittany Elaine Hormel, magna cum laude. Nicole Fernandez Ellison, cum laude. Alma Teresa Velasquez. Tyshana Halvey. Cassidy Nicole Rogers. Daniel Barnhart Woomer. Jessica Nicole Ladry, cum laude. Mary Frances Ramey. Kyra Mahaffey Waite, summa cum laude. Jordan Elizabeth Adcox. Hunter Josiah Carswell, cum laude. Alexis Pollard, magna cum laude. Sierra Michael Crony. Caroline Avery Blue. Cameron Lee Wood, cum laude. Jonathan Brock Collins. Tomas Joseph Carrillo. McKenna Clarice Colley. Catherine Sean Hefner. Luke Crozier. Caitlin Nicole Stiles. Aaron Mackenzie Martin. Mac P. Cristino, cum laude. Amber Michelle Thompson. Hannah Virginia Ruth. Allison Mae Sturkin. Tina Marie Hamer, summa cum laude. Brandolyn Elizabeth Allison, cum laude. Madison Rose Kitchen. Stephanie Annalise Dillingham, magna cum laude. Destiny Marie Easter. Megan Sheree Eckstein. David Alexander Pope. Keontae Rocky Graham. Mava Christine Hassani, cum laude. Cassandra Marie Coker, magna cum laude. Trace Robinson Wooten, summa cum laude. Jessie Mariah Dennison. Reagan Elizabeth Brown, cum laude. Stephanie Renee Ewing. Isabel Ann Martinez. Jordan Leanne Simpson. Allison Grace Ward. Morgan Elizabeth Robinson, magna cum laude. Mayla K. Jennings. Brandon Robert Olandez, cum laude. Thomas Howard Meek IV, summa cum laude. Ashley Sierra Locklear. Daira Yeruti Mendez Vega, cum laude. Douglas Lee Watts, summa cum laude. Ashley Ann Cannata, summa cum laude. Iris Laurel Miller, magna cum laude. Maya Adriana McClaney, cum laude. Tyler David Ebersold. Ava Raluca Scales. Autumn Kayens Chandler, cum laude. Dylan Leewood Holloman, summa cum laude. Taylor D. Margaret Hicks. Clarice Jordan Brown, summa cum laude. Destiny Lane Davis, cum laude. Josie Ann Porch, magna cum laude. Kaylee Gress Bird. Ainsley Jude McNeil. Gatlin Davis Cruz. Mason Charles Ledford, summa cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Hamaker, cum laude. Ebony N. Blake. Jessica Nicole Fail. Madeline Ray Dunn, magna cum laude. Evelyn Aleman Vidales. Logan Marie Iwanek. Damian Christopher Gregory, cum laude. Hazel Colkia Martin, cum laude. Austin Kincaid Woods. Matthew Alexander Moore, magna cum laude. Talicia Zimmerman. Kale McCoy Harris.
Chancellor Brown, all candidates for degrees have now been presented.
While we allow our graduates to all line up. Yeah. 1. Oh my, the dean of the Honors College, our chair, and the head of staff senate? Come on now. Anyway, okay. Now, the moment that you all been waiting for. Graduates, please rise. Graduates, now move your tassel to the left to signify the earning of your undergraduate degree. Congratulations. You may be seated. You are now alumni of Western Carolina University, and now I introduce Mr. Neil Andrews, president of the Alumni Association, to greet you as alumni colleagues.
Thank you, Chancellor Brown. Has anyone told you folks recently just how awesome you look in purple? You do. Good afternoon, Catamount family. My name is Neil Andrews, and I am the WCU Alumni Association president. And it is truly my pleasure to congratulate you on your accomplishments today and welcome you to the ranks of Western Carolina University alumni. I want to remind you today that you make a very meaningful transition. Up until now, it's been the university's role to fill you with knowledge and give you the skills necessary to pursue your future. But you leave here today with a new role as an alumni. You will represent WCU to your friends, your family, your employers, your colleagues, and to all of those who will come to know you in the years ahead. You have made memories here in the WE that will last you a lifetime, but I want to encourage you not to let this be the end of your Catamount story. Today, you received an alumni lapel pin from WCU's Office of Alumni Engagement, and I encourage you to wear that and wear it proudly. Stay connected and involved with WCU. Participate in alumni events and keep your network strong and make new connections. Take advantage of the services that remain available to you through the Center for Career and Professional Development. Return to WCU to share your experiences with future generations of Catamounts. Make WCU a philanthropic priority, as your financial contributions can make a difference in the lives of students who are going to be following your footsteps. Most of all, remain part of what makes this place so special, the community. The class of 2021 is going to go down in WCU history as a very special class, one of incredible resolve and resiliency. The strength that you have displayed in the face of adversity during the COVID pandemic is an inspiration to us all. I look forward to continuing to serve as your Alumni Association president and hearing about all of the wonderful things that you will be doing. Congratulations, and now go prove your purple, Catamounts.
Thank you, Neil, and thank you for all your support as our alumni president. Before we conclude, let me acknowledge some special individuals who are part of our ceremony today. First, I would like to salute all members of our graduating class who are veterans, active duty, guard, and reserve members. Western Carolina University takes great pride in being a military-friendly university, and we are proud of you. Would those students please stand so that we may express our appreciation for your service? Thank you. Next, let me recognize the families of our graduates. Will the parents or guardians of our graduates please stand? Continue to stand, please. Will the spouses and children of our graduates please stand? Will the grandparents and other family members of our graduates please stand? Will the special friends of our graduates please stand? Please continue standing. While you are standing, it is my pleasure to invite our graduates to rise and show their appreciation to you for your love, support, and commitment to their future. Thank you. You may be seated. A ceremony like this does not just happen. Please join me in thanking the army of staff colleagues from every part of campus who had a part in making this ceremony a very special occasion for us all. At the conclusion of this ceremony, we ask that the audience exit the Ramsey Regional Activity Center as quickly as possible so that we can sanitize for our next ceremony. Thanks to all of you who have joined us today to share this momentous occasion in the life of our university. Now rise as we sing the alma mater led by Ms. Shropshire and remain standing for the recessional. Following the recessional, this ceremony will be concluded. Again, congratulations, graduates, and go Cats!
Every song and dance. Thank you.